So the Vancouver Canucks take defeat today to the LA Kings, and to be honest with you, I'm not that upset about the loss in itself, it is what it is. What I'm more mad at is the royal waste of time that was watching LA Kings hockey for a full 60 minutes. I mean, that's gotta be some form of torture out there, because holy does this team love to sit on a lead and do nothing about it as the clock just slowly drains down. I mean, don't get me wrong, it's very effective when done well, but by no means does that make that enjoyable for anyone to watch. But the LA Kings did it, I gotta give them respect, they won the game fair and square. And despite the Kings' play style, this game did have its moments. It was very physical. These teams clearly do not like each other. This game had the third most hits out of any NHL game this season. And in the last 5 minutes or so, the Vancouver Canucks really turned up the pace and made something out of this game. Had me on the edge of my seat for what was a very dramatic finale. We're gonna dive into all of that, but before we do, let's start off with the first period of this hockey game. To start off the hockey game, it's Big Z with a huge hit there on Blake Lizotte, sends him flying. And listen, I've said it before, I'll say it again.
Sign the contract, big boy, sign the contract.
I think I've made my point pretty clear. Anyways, the Kings get themselves on the board first. It's Kevin Fiala who's left open in the slot. Probably not the right guy you want to leave open, but the Canucks are a bit mismatched in their own zone. Don't even have the correct amount of players on the ice. PLD over to Fiala, he gets it by DeSmith, 1-0 for the Kings. It's all good, we keep going, because the Canucks' fourth line is an absolute powerhouse. Look at Pod Colson here with this hit, makes the Kings player cough up the puck, and then Sam Lafferty gets it, and for some reason, he decides, hey, I'm McDavid right now. Goes through about three Kings players, takes it around Talbot, and ties this game up 1-1. Beautiful play from these two boys, Pod Colson with the assist. I'm telling you, man, this guy on the forecheck is something else. The period ends 1-1 as we move forward to the second. Midway through the second period, and the Canucks have a golden opportunity to go up ahead 2-1 in this game. Mikheyev picks up a rebound with a spinning shot, but unfortunately Cam Talbot is there to recover and gets his pad on it. Since the Kings really don't give you much throughout the entirety of a game, this would have been a really good one to score, but unfortunately it wasn't the case, and we were faced with a bit of a different reality, starting off here with a pretty unlucky play from Soucy, as he takes a penalty, and then on the delayed call, puck gets thrown in front, and it goes off of his skate after pinballing like four times, and ends up in the back of the net. Bit of a rough shift, but we move. Anyways, it gets even worse, because about a minute and a half later, the Kings get themselves another goal. Scramble in front, the Canucks can't get it out, and Kopitar is there after going behind the net, finds the loose puck, and bats it home by Casey DeSmith. And with that, the Canucks are down two going into the third period. If we wanted any chance at coming back in this game, we were gonna have to come out firing in the third period. For about the first three quarters of the third period, the Canucks really weren't able to generate that many good scoring chances, which wasn't ideal. But boy, did they turn it on near the end. But before we get to that, I would like to present you all with a masterclass in hockey. Today, I want to share with you Drew Doughty's highlights from this hockey game. It's just breathtaking stuff, to be honest with you. No one does it quite like my boy Drew here. Incredible form, really no room for improvement. But if you watch the game, you know exactly what I'm talking about. I can't find the clip online, but Drew Doughty basically ran into Besser and then acted like he got blown up in an action movie. Don't worry, your Oscar is waiting for you in the locker room. But whatever, what do you do? And Pod Colson does the entire hockey world a massive favor, as later on in the game he's fighting for a puck, and then on the follow-through catches Doughty with a high stick, right in the mouth, serves you right for diving, and it comes back to bite you later. He deserved that, man. Complained to the ref, it was funny to see that happen. Anyways, the Canucks late make a push, Brock Besser takes a shot, and the Canucks get themselves a little bit of luck as it goes off of Kopitar's skate and gets by Talbot. 3-2 for the Kings late in the game, Pedersen draws a penalty so the Canucks have a power play with 20 seconds to go, but they're unable to get that equalizer, and the Kings come away with the W and remain third place in the Pacific Division. A dramatic finish to cap this one off, but for a majority of this game, it was not the most enjoyable experience to watch the 1-3-1 for about 55 minutes. But I digress. We look forward now to Thursday as the Vancouver Canucks have themselves a little bit of a break. I'll be making some other videos in the meantime, but for now, the Canucks are still first place. We're all good. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below on this hockey game. My two questions to you in the comments: what are your thoughts on the LA Kings playstyle? And who was your MVP for the Vancouver Canucks in this game? Anyways, that's all from me, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll be sure to catch you in the next one. Make sure you like and subscribe if you're new. And yeah, man, peace out and take care.